So, have you ever been afraid of something? Especially around Halloween, there's all kind of things that get into our imaginations. Because most of the things that we are afraid of, in fact, all of them, start in our imagination. And because they're there, it means that we have put thought into them. And because then we choose what we feel about them, then it becomes fear. But in reality, nothing is either good or bad. It's really neutral, you know, kind of like money is. Some people are really afraid of money. I know I have been afraid of money just because I feel like I don't have enough, or I'm not going to make enough, or where is it going? All that stuff means absolutely nothing until you realize it's neutral, and it's about how you feel about money. So if you feel good about money, whether you have a penny or you have $1 million, it will come to you. You just have to feel that first. I know when I do that, I start making more money. It's the funniest thing. So it's kind of like seeing through darkness, right? When you see through darkness, you don't even notice the darkness. The darkness does not exist. And an owl, what do? They see through darkness. And I know many crazy, maybe evil people have used that symbol as evil, but it's really not evil. It's not evil because it's neutral. It's only evil based on what they or you or anyone else puts a feeling and a thought towards. So I was telling my friend the other day that there's a baby owl on the dollar bill. Well, at least it looks like it to me. And I don't know really the real reason why it's there. I have ideas and I could maybe, you know, explain that, but it really doesn't matter. Because in reality, it really matters what I think and feel when I see and think of something. So money's kind of interesting. If you really look at that owl like it's a good thing and it's shining light to you and everything else in the world, and then you look at the reason why you want money because of the things it can buy and do and make you feel good. So in reality, you can actually turn a symbol into what you want it to do and what you want it to remind you of. So think of the owl as seeing through darkness. So the darkness disappears and you basically are the light. So today I thought it'd be cute to make an owl. Instead of hooting in the dark, we're gonna make him turn on a little light. Let's get started. Okay, so to make our owl, I'm going to use some black foam board that you can buy anywhere. And I'm gonna draw out my owl silhouette shape. And I'm gonna kind of make him look like he's on a branch somewhat. And then I'm gonna take an X-Acto knife and actually just cut him out like that so he has a clean lines. And then I'll show you how we're gonna get him to look like he's hanging up high in a tree. It needs such a hoot. Anyway, I've already got him cut out. I found these like lead lights you can actually put in water like for flower vases. But I thought these look like eyeballs and they're quite beautiful. So I'm actually just gonna stick them through the holes here and just put a little bit of tape on the back so that way they'll adhere. And I mean, it kind of gives him a really cool outlook on life. Okay, now that you've got your owl seeing correctly, you need to get one of those little closet lights that you can like snap on. And we're actually gonna adhere the light to the back of our owl. Okay, so now to put him on the wall and appear like he's on a branch, yet giving us enough space so the light will shine on the wall, just get a cheap 90 cents little curtain rod. And we're just gonna attach the bottom of it, the branch that we've created with our foam board, to that. You just hang it on the wall. And then you'll see how cute and really a hoot he will be.